I'd like to turn over now to Jordan Cunningham, Deanna Rockwell, Michael Jackson, and Daniel Williams, and they're going to give us a very short presentation.
Hello. Good morning, everyone. My name is Michael Jackson. We as learners have created a presentation about Martin Luther King and his dream. So it is talking about his dream back then and how it is now and how we can keep his dream living on into the future. So now we'll discuss his journey. So Martin Luther King Jr. was born on January 15, 1929 in Atlanta, Georgia. He was born with a birth name Michael. His father was inspired by a German Protestant Reformation leader named Martin Luther. So in 1934, Martin's father changed their name. He was also a middle child of four different children.
My name is Xavier Warriors. I'm discussing King's education. When he was 15, he went to Morehouse College in Atlanta. He met us in the law for his senior year. He changed his major to ministry. In 48, he went to the Ozark Theological Seminary in Pennsylvania, where he became familiar with Gandhi's tactics, and he received a Bachelor's of Divinity in 51. He was, although the majority of his class was white, he was an excellent student body, and he received a doctorate in medical. In 1953, he married Loretta Scott. You know, 15 years married, they had two children. He became a pastor at Dexter Avenue Baptist Church in Montgomery, where he learned about Rosa Parks, and that's what kicked off his White House movements.
My name is Deanna Rockwell, and I'm going to share Martin Luther King's Jr. Martin Luther King Jr. lived in a time where there were no equal rights for all people. Dr. King pushed forward developing a nation where everyone, no matter what race, religion, or where they came from, will be able to stand together with their fellow Americans as brothers and sisters. During Dr. King's time, segregation is no longer prevalent, but his dream still carried his powerful message. The dream was not only about racial equality, but also gender equality and equality for everyone and every socioeconomic status. We should talk our problems out and make change through perseverance. Dr. King never resorted to violence because violence is never the answer. It only strengthens the opposing side and will cause further division among our people.
My name is Jordan, and I will be discussing Dr. King's dream and how it can continue on into the future through us as high schoolers and people in our society. Each of us decided to pick a small sentence out of Dr. King's I Have a Dream speech and discuss why it meant something to us personally and how we can use that to carry on throughout our lives.
So the excerpt that I chose from Martin Luther King's speech is, "Let us not seek to satisfy our thirst for freedom by drinking from the cup of bitterness and hatred." This meant something to me because Martin Luther King had peaceful movements, which he didn't have bitterness and hatred to find freedom for others. So this really meant a lot to show others how we can all work together without having bitterness and hatred. So, for example, when Martin would have his walks, or when people couldn't sit on the front of the bus, they would have calm and peaceful movements to where even though others were using hatred and bitterness, they always stayed calm and collective.
I charge you, we refuse to believe that medical justice is bankrupt. As the founders of the United States wrote a check for freedom, denying freedom and equality for us all makes a check bounce, but we have the funds in the bank to make that dream come alive. And if you believe this, tomorrow there will be no further decision or limitation.
We cannot walk alone is the quote that I chose because I think that we should all stand together no matter what and help each other despite of our differences in order to preserve peace and unity in our nation.
I chose now is the time to lift our nation from quicksands of racial injustice to the solid rock of brotherhood. I chose this because it chose the point that our country was in quicksands to say where we were stuck in a time where there is discrimination and mistreatment towards someone just because of their color or some things that they chose to do. So now we have come out of that hole and we continue on as a rock of, as brothers and sisters to form a solid rock. The learners at Renaissance Academy made a video to explain how Dr. King's dream lived then, how it can live now, and how it can live into the future with us being brothers and sisters as one and getting along together.
I have a dream.
That my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin or by the content of their character.
I have a dream that one day in Alabama, suspicious racism,
and its governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification.
One day right there in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able
to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today.
So finally, we want you to leave here today remembering that Dr. King wanted all of us to get along together and overcome our differences just because of a certain look that someone had. If we remember this, then we can get along and we can continue to live peacefully in the world. Thank you.